What the heck is mid-tone contrast? Well, inside this video, I'm going to show you one crazy Lightroom technique you can use to add so much pop and color to your images without it feeling unnatural. You ready? Let's get into it. All right, guys, Ryan here at Signature Edits. We're gonna dive right into this image taken by Mr. Davey Gravy, awesome YouTuber, and add some punch to this image by adding contrast. And you're gonna see there's some issues that happen as we take this higher and higher and higher. Our blacks in this image getting completely clipped and our whites are getting really blown out. It just doesn't look nice. Here's where mid-tone contrast comes in, because we don't want to actually add contrast to our shadows or to our highlights, we just wanna add it to the rest of the image. So what I'm gonna do is I'm going to hit Shift Q on my keyboard. You can also go up here to where it says Create New Mask and just go Select Luminance Range, okay? From there, you get this little eyedropper, and we're gonna look for an area in the image that isn't super bright and isn't super dark, so something kind of in the midtones. Let's grab this field over here and just click. Okay, so Lightroom's made a selection, and it selected all the similar brightness areas in that image, and you can adjust it with these little sliders here. This is kind of the feathering to extend that range down. This is the main selection here, which you can enlarge or shrink, and here's the top end, where you can really dial in how much of the brights you want to grab and how much you want to leave alone. Let's stick with this for now. I'm going to take that same contrast slider on this mask now. I'm going to drag it up, 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 and you're going to see that we're adding pop and color to the image, but we're not affecting the sky and we're leaving those shadows completely alone. So we can really add some pop and some punch to our images without it making any drastic changes to our highlights, which we don't want to blow out, or our really, really dark shadows, which we don't want to affect. And what's so cool about this technique is you can actually use it for different areas of your image. So that was on the midtones, but now I can do a totally separate one by hitting Shift Q on my keyboard and just select the sky this time. Let's go with the brightest parts of the image. Okay, we've grabbed the brightest parts. Now I can maybe dial the highlights back. I'm gonna add a little contrast, drop the blacks, and we've added some punch to our sky without blowing it up. So here's before and here's after in that one little mask. Do it again with Shift Q on my keyboard or Create New Mask down here to Luminance Range, and let's select the darkest parts of the image. So I'm gonna click right in there. And Lightroom said, here's all the shadows, Ryan. Perfect, thank you, Lightroom. I'm gonna take the shadows up to make them a little bit brighter, but then I'm also gonna add some contrast to them. So by doing this, you can get really, really specific on the contrast you want to add to your image and where you're doing it. So I've taken this really far intentionally to show you one last little trick that comes with this. You can grab all of these and put them on a little slider up here and dial in exactly how much you want. So if you take it too far and it's like, oh, that's unnatural in the shadows, just dial it back a little bit. And I always seem to take things too far. So this is perfect for me because I can dial it in where I think it looks good, then take it back to like 70, 80%, I'll get a much more natural result. So let's take a look at a couple other images and see some other ways we can add selective contrast. And if this video is helpful so far, hit that thumbs up and leave me a comment below. Did you know this existed? And if so, why didn't you tell me? Okay, here's another image, very, very similar, also taken by Davey Gravy, awesome guy. So here it is, and if I add contrast, same problem, but if I hit Shift Q on my keyboard, and then I go in here and find an area of midtones. Let's go with these cliffs back there. It's going to select just the midtone areas and I can add some contrast. And you're gonna see that if I take this too far, it starts looking just not good. I can't tell you exactly the physics of how Lightroom has set this up, but I can tell you that it's going to start smooshing things instead of adding contrast. It'll feel like you're losing contrast. And we don't want that. Here's a much better way to do this that I've found works a lot better than just using this contrast slider. Grab your highlights and take them down a little bit. Take your shadows up a little bit, and then dial in your contrast by increasing the whites and decreasing the blacks. And by doing this, we can add a lot more punch to our images and get a much more natural result than just using that contrast slider. So we've added that same amount of punch without losing anything, and we can dial this in specifically so that we can even recover some highlights and get some extra shadows back and get more information in the image, and then just add that contrast as much as we need with the blacks and the whites. So here's before and here's after. And of course, I've gone too far, so I can grab that amount slider overall and just slide that back until I get a natural result. So here's without, and here's with. Much better than if I just went into Lightroom and added contrast with this one slider. Okay, let's look at some other examples, and I want to show you one other way you can use this in a technique that doesn't just use a luminance range slider, but uses a color range slider. So let's take this photo here. There's Davey sitting in front of the lake looking like the gentleman that he is. So we'll adjust our brightness just a little bit. And let's use our same technique. I'm gonna hit Shift Q on my keyboard. I'm gonna grab the midtones. Let's go with this area on the lake. Okay, I'm gonna lower my highlights a little bit, raise my shadows a little bit, raise the whites, lower the blacks, and we've added a ton of punch to the midtones right there. Okay, that's looking good, but we've also affected our sky and we don't really wanna do that. So there's two options. One option would be to go in here and dial back our highlights a little bit to make sure we're not affecting them too much. Or we can go up here to our luminance range slider. We can actually just toggle this back and forth to find exactly what part of the image we want this to affect. So somewhere around there feels a lot better to me. There's before and there's after. Now, this is a super powerful tool, and using luminance ranges is definitely a great way to edit your photos. But here's another thing you can stack on top of it. Instead of hitting Shift Q on your keyboard, try hitting Shift J. That's going to pull up the color range mask. So I can use the same eyedropper tool and place it on my friend Davey here. Now you're going to see it selected his jacket, and I can go in here and add some contrast or take it away. I can make my highlights brighter on his jacket, the whites brighter on his jacket, and I've added contrast to the image, but only to a specific color in the image. The same thing can be applied to this yellow set of trees. So let's hit Shift J again on our keyboard, or go Create New Mask and go down here to Color Range. I'm going to select these yellow trees this time and add some contrast just to the yellow in the image and really make those fall colors pop. At the same time, let's raise the highlights, raise the whites, and you can see that I've really made those trees just shine in a way that they weren't before, and that just by doing a luminance mask, we wouldn't have been able to, because it would have added contrast to everything instead of selectively to one part of the image. Cool. So if this is helpful for you so far, again, hit that thumbs up button for me. Leave a comment. How can you see this applying in your images? Because I am finding a million ways to apply it in mine. Let's check out a few more images. And if you do want to grab practice files, you can head to signatureedits.com/free-raw-photos, and that'll give you free raw files that you can practice on yourself to work on your Lightroom skills. Okay, let's head over here, take a look at this photo. We're going to apply our luminance range mask. So I'm going to go up here, create new mask, luminance range, and let's just start by selecting our midtones. Now, I can take my shadows up a little bit just to make those areas brighter. Maybe take my whites up a little bit and my blacks down just a little. Add a little bit of contrast, and you can see the difference that just that one little mask made, but I'm not really losing a ton of detail by blowing out my highlights or losing information in the shadows. So let's try again. We're going to go Shift Q. This time I'm going to select the dark parts of the image, these trees here, and I'm actually just going to take those shadows right up. I'm going to add a little bit of contrast, raise the whites just a little bit, and drop the blacks very, very slightly. Okay, so now I've gotten all that detail back in those trees without actually having to go through and make a mask. It's super simple just by using this luminance range mask rather than trying to do it just with an auto mask or something like that. And of course, everything is always too extreme in my edit, so I'm gonna dial that back. I'm gonna take this edit, and I'm going to dial that one back. And you can see we've gone from here to here with just a couple of masks, no presets required. All right, this is a great one because we've got so much dynamic range. I'm gonna show you what it's capable of. So I'm gonna grab a Signature Edits base set, apply that, and that'll give us a decent look. We'll add some warmth to our image. That's looking pretty cool to me. We're definitely having some issues when it comes to the actual dark parts of this image and the bright parts. We really wanna kind of control that dynamic range. So let's hit Shift Q on our keyboard, and we're going to grab our midtones, probably this lake area. That's what I'm looking for. We can recover the highlights a little bit, raise the shadows a little bit, raise up those whites just a little, and blacks down a bit. So here's what we've done in the midtones. We've added some contrast, it's looking great, and we haven't blown out any highlights, we haven't clipped any shadows. Now we'll do another one. This time I'm gonna hit Shift J on my keyboard. This time, let's just select this blue water here, and I'm gonna let Lightroom think, select all the blue in this image. Let's try again somewhere else on the image. Right there, grab all that blue, and we're just gonna try and make it more of a teal and less of like a sky blue. So we'll add some green to it, adjust the white balance a little bit. We can even grab our contrast, bring that up. Shadows, bring it down a little bit. Whites, bring it up. And we've added a ton of blue color to our lake here. Really made it pop. Do one more, we're gonna go with Shift Q this time. Select these trees. Let's try and recover some of the information in the shadows. I'm gonna bring the contrast down. Highlights up, whites up a little bit. Okay, that's looking a little bit better to me. And then I'm gonna dial it in because I've taken it too far, somewhere around there. Okay, so here's before we did anything with our masks, and here's after. So this is a super handy, powerful tool, especially when you're adding contrast selectively to different parts of your image, whether you're selecting by color or by luminance. By doing this, you can stack these little changes one by one and make much more natural images rather than trying to do a big effect on one mask at a time. So in this photo here, obviously it's got a ton of contrast to begin with, and if we add any more contrast, we're gonna lose this sky, we're gonna really clip the dark parts of this image. So instead, let's go up here, hit Shift Q. Let's start by just selecting the midtones in this image. I'm gonna go with somewhere around there, the gray on the lake. Okay, that looks pretty good. Let's take our highlights down, our shadows up a little bit, our whites up, and our blacks down. So we've added a bunch of contrast just to the midtones, really made the image pop, but you can see we've left the sky more or less alone, and we're not affecting any of the shadow areas. Now we can go in here and go Shift J. That'll do a color mask, and let's just select the blues in this image. Go into color. Let's add some green so that lake really gets popping. Cool the temperature down a little bit. We've totally added a ton of color to the lake and to all the blues in the image. Perfect. Now let's go Shift Q again. We're going to grab the highlights of this image this time. Okay, just the bright parts of the image. So I actually want to recover some of those highlights to get some of the sky information back. So let's go with something like that. And you can see that if I take this too far, you're going to get issues with your mask where it's just not blending. And that's where these tools come in handy. You can adjust the feathers so that you're really getting a nice blend and it's not an obvious mask. But that only matters if you've got intense effects. If you're not noticing the blend, then you're probably all right. Okay, so let's just pull the exposure down a little bit. Highlights down a little bit, and you can see we've recovered that entire sky. And it took like 2 seconds. I didn't have to do a ton of masking, ton of complicated adjustments, but we've really recovered a lot of dynamic range. And then last of all, let's go Shift J and try selecting just this orange color, because I find that's kind of too saturated in the image overall. So I'm going to take the color and just take the saturation down in the oranges a little bit, and maybe take the contrast down just a slight amount. Okay, so in just a few masks, we've gone from here to here. Awesome. Added so much color, but I don't think it looks over-edited the way that it would if I had gone in here and tried to adjust my contrast, adjust my saturation to the entire image at once. Let's look at a couple more images. So this one's an interesting case because we can go Shift-J, grab their skin tones, and on the skin tones, let's try taking the contrast up. Perfect. Now let's go Shift-J again, and let's grab the greens in this image. Let's take the contrast up, the shadows down, the blacks down, just really make those greens pop. Shift-J. Q this time, that's going to do a luminance mask. We're going to grab this part of the beach. That's kind of grabbing all of the tan tones in this image. We'll take the exposure down a little bit, maybe add a little bit of contrast. And then let's go Shift Q again. And I'm just going to select the yellows in this image. And we're going to be able to find, we can add some temperature, add some warmth. So again, this is just showing you a really quick edit, what's possible. I've gone way too far here, but if I actually go in with my masks, you can see the amount of changes we can make in just a few clicks. Let's look at a couple more because I find this really fun. If you're finding it helpful or you have other questions, leave those in the comments below. I'd love to hear where you can see this being used and where I might have spent a little bit more time explaining things. I'd be happy to do that in the comments. Okay, so this one, overexposed, we'll adjust that. And you can see that their skin tone's not looking super, super great. Two ways we could adjust those. We could try using a luminance mask with Shift Q. Go in here, click on their skin. You can see it's doing an okay job, but it's not really masking just their skin. So let's try Shift J, and then we can just click on their skin once. Perfect, we've selected it. Now we can grab our contrast, bring that down. Highlights, bring that down a little bit to recover those. And let's go into color, bring some saturation down. And then I'm gonna add some color up here. I'm gonna add some orange back into their skin. Somewhere around there. Okay, so now we've done this with our skin. We've added some color. Now let's do the same kind of mask trick. We're going to go Shift Q, select these kind of shadow areas of the greens, and we can go in here, maybe make the white balance a little bit cooler, add some more green to them, desaturate, maybe increase the contrast, and we'll get some more pop in that image just a little bit. Right, and so you can see, it's easy to screw this up. And so that's where you can play around with these sliders, you can adjust them, you can dial back the amount so that it looks more natural. It's all about just practicing and seeing what you can discover for yourself, because that's the easiest and fastest way to learn is actually applying this. So grab some of the free raw files at the website, signatureedit.com/free-raw-photos, and give this a try for yourself, because you'll learn so much more than just watching me in this tutorial. So hopefully you found this tutorial helpful, and I've shown you a couple of new tricks you can use when it comes to adding vibrance and really nice saturated colors to your image without making it look super unnatural. If you want some free presets, you can check those in the link below. Give this video a thumbs up if it brought you some value, and subscribe if you want more content like this. I'll see you in the next video. In the meantime, create something awesome. Peace.